Hey guys, and I'm back with another video. So today's video is unboxing time, guys. I already told y'all I was ordering things. So I told y'all I had some shoes coming. So yeah, drum roll please. So I'm about to open it up. Let's see what we got. Have you all been watching The Shy Guys? It's really getting interesting, guys. I can't wait till next Sunday. So I'm glad they finally found Keisha, guys. Like, I'm so thankful for Ronnie. Like, he did the damn thing. Like, it was sad that Ronnie's grandmother had died. She passed away. And, Ronnie was about to go with his friends. His friends wanted him to go. They had moved. I don't know where they was. Down south somewhere. And they basically was saying they had work for him. They had a place for him to stay and everything. But his mission, he was on a mission. His mission was to find Keisha, which he did. You know what I'm saying? He was not going to give up. And I thank God he didn't give up. So it was just like, I felt so sad for Keisha, but she was being a little, you know, too grown, you know, a little too promiscuous. I didn't like that at all, you know. But I think now this is really going to change her. This is going to change her ways because, you know, she wasn't listening to, like, her mom. And she just was thinking she knew everything. Not saying that, you know, that should have happened to her because nobody should be kidnapped or, you know, abused or anything like that. You know what I'm saying? But she was a little out of pocket. She wasn't listening, you know, hanging with older men and, you know, just being reckless. So, yeah. Let me show y'all. Yay, guys! Look at my shoes. I need to. Hold on, guys. I'm about to get up and get my little socks. Tell me how y'all like these. These are the purple camouflage foam posits. Purple is my favorite color, of course. So y'all already know. I'm gonna hook these bad boys up. They wasn't in the store no more. I had to order them, guys. I want y'all to tell me how it look. But yeah, I really feel like, you know, Keisha's mom, wife, Dre, I believe she has something to do with, you know, Keisha's disappearance. Because when Keisha was found and Keisha was in a hospital, her and Ronnie was in a hospital, the doctor or the nurse or however had walked past Dre and said, "Here goes some pamphlets. I wanted to give it to you to give to your daughter." And, you know, she might have like suicide thoughts and stuff like that, but y'all gotta keep a close eye on her and, you know, just show her love and support at this time or however. Dre looked like she didn't even want to accept the pamphlet. She was like, I already know, you know, I'm a school counselor. I already know how to handle this type of situation. But she really looked like she didn't even want to take the pamphlets at all, like, because she's guilty. And when she walked back in the room, in Keisha's room, and she seen her wife and Keisha, like, snuggled up together, she started crying. Because she guilty about something. I believe that's the coach, the one that had her hostage. And I believe Dre probably paid him, or they was working together. But it's going, you know, it's going to come to fruition. It's going some, they're going to find out if Dre had something to do with it. I just don't trust her. She just seems sneaky, and you could tell in her eyes like she got something to do with Keisha's disappearance. But I thank God they found Keisha, but Keisha just need to, you know, stop being so grown and, you know, hanging with all these grown men. Like, I think she's only supposed to be like, what, like 17, 16, 17 years old on the show. And, you know, she was dating a coach that was like 30, 20, 30 something years old. Like, you know, you know, when you be grown, that's when, you know, bad things happen to you. You know what I'm saying? So before she disappeared, her mom and Dre had went on the anniversary, or not the anniversary, but the honeymoon. And she was supposed to be watching Kevin. But instead, you know, she went out being grown, trying to hang with her boyfriend, which she be dating guys that's way older than her. They be like 20 something or 30 something years old, and she only like 17. So, you know, that's just not a good look. But I thank God they found her, and they found her alive. You know, I can't wait to next Sunday episode. But I don't like the way Emmett is doing Tiffany. He sat right there and slept with Lala. And that damn psychic, she was right about him. She was right about him. She said he couldn't keep his D inside of his pants, and that Tiffany need to watch him. And that was right. Tiffany need to leave his ass alone. But I like Emmett too. He was doing so good, you know, by Tiffany. They was getting along, and, you know, I thought they was gonna work out this season, but I don't know, you know. That make it seem like all men is dogs, even though all men aren't dogs. But, you know, you see how the power of the P changed his mind, changed. He went from being loyal to his baby mother to, you know, Lala want, giving it up to him, and he just taking it instead of him saying, no, I'm loyal to my girlfriend, my baby mother, like, I don't, you know what I'm saying? We can't do this. Let's just keep it strictly business. You know, we just business partners. I don't want nothing to do with you like that. But it lets you know the power of the P rules everything. And he couldn't even be loyal to his baby mother. And that's messed up. But I hope you all like my shoes, guys. Please comment down below. Tell me what y'all think about my purple camouflage foam posits. And I'll see y'all on the next one. Bye, guys.